hell up, every shup, it's the Polterthup, 5,000 up, and welcome back to Dark Souls. In the last episode, we talked to Princess Guinevere. I was trying to make a joke, and all I could think about was in Super Ghouls and Ghosts at the end of the credits sequence, at the end of the cast call, when it shows Princess Prin. And it shows her measurements on the floor. And I was going to make a joke about how Guinevere's measurements would all be in, like, quadruple digits. Because she's, like, fucking huge and also, like, super stacked. But I couldn't... That was far too layered conceptually for it to possibly work. Why am I not warping? Shit. Forgot I had this thing. There we go. So in the last episode, we talked to Princess Guinevere. You know, it's funny, because, like, I think in Tim's LP of Super Ghouls and Ghosts, he actually thought her name was Guinevere. He was like, this is the princess. What's her name? Princess Guinevere? No, Princess Prin. But anyway... So, yeah, we talked to Guinevere, and we got the Lordvessel from her, which we're still carrying around, I think. No, that's not how you... That's how you do it in the other game, in Dark Souls 3, not this one. The Lordvessel, soul vessel granted to the chosen undead. Lordvessel bestowed upon the chosen undead who is destined to... I can't read! Holy shit! Hey, Sigmire, what's up?
Well, fancy meeting you here.
Why, yes, it was.
Yes, I knew it.
I knew it.
Unlikely coincidence. Well, I thought it. This light of Catalina thanks you sincerely. Please, take this as a token of my gratitude.
Of my gratitude, or and does it require an explosive force of great magnitude? Oh.
No worries. Venturing is my life.
Okay, anyway. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna turn the voice volume up. Oh. Never mind, I guess I'm not going to do that. I forgot that I maxed it out already. Okay, well. Okay, so what you do with the Lordvessel is you come over here and you talk to... Scary Snake Man! What's up, dog?
Heavens!
Heavens!
I've done it.
You have retrieved the Lordvessel!
The Lordvessel! After 1,000 years.
Man, so happy. Man, so happy. How happy can you get?
Forgive me. I really should calm down. Now.
I'm never gonna get over this guy's voice. Like, the fact that he looks like that and sounds like that. It's just so hilarious. What are you doing? Oh, God! No! Oh, dear. Well. Here we go. Man, this area is so creepy. These Kingseekers, he is not a Kingseeker. That's his, like, title, not his species. He is actually, I believe he's referred to as a primordial serpent. Firelink Altar. And if you look behind you, he looks really freaky in here. He's like, oh, God! God, that angle just seeing him from this angle with his, like, I don't even know what you'd call those, his, like, growths. Like, his mustache, like, falling up. God, it just looks so wrong. Anyway. Walk up to this thingy, and you place the Lordvessel, and thankfully this doesn't... Putting it down here doesn't cause you to lose the ability to warp between bonfires, otherwise that would really suck. But by doing this... Oh, you know what I just realized? I never showed any of the places where you couldn't pass before you did this. There's like 4 gates. Are there 4? Yeah, there are 4. I think there are 4 places in the game. Whoa! Dude, it's like... It's like in Banjo-Tooie when you solve the puzzles in Jiggy Wiggy's temple and the Crystal Jiggy shoots that beam of light. Now it's gonna cut to all the little world doors opening. That's in the Tomb of the Giants. That's actually to the left coming out of the first bonfire in Anor Londo. That's down at the Demon Ruins where we fought the Ceaseless Discharge. And... oh, that's it. Okay. I guess I thought there was one in New Londo Ruins too, but now this place actually functions as a bonfire, which is cool. I think I can level up too. Yeah, let's level up. What do we want? I still need to put more into you. I'm gonna keep putting endurance in so I can put something on besides Havel's ring. Hey, dude.
Very well. As King Seed,
man. What is this place? This is like... Yes. Okay. So he's telling us to go find the great souls. And he's telling us all the... where to go. And basically, it's the same people we saw in the opening cutscene. Well, we didn't see them because I skipped it! But there's... there's four of them. There's... You saw one of them, Cephas Scaleless. There's also Gravelord Nito. The Witch of Izalith. It might be Izalith, I'm not actually sure. Dude, your whiskers are going crazy there. You alright? And the fourth one is... oh, hey.
Oh, hello.
Oh, hello there. Man, where have I heard your voice? Where have I heard your voice in something else completely unrelated recently? I've heard an accent like that in something else, but I can't put my finger upon it. So yeah, now that we've placed the Lordvessel, we can go to those other areas. Hey, wait a second, it just occurred to me. No, okay, never mind. I was gonna say, how could you possibly do the deal? I'm still thinking about that thing in the last episode that I mentioned, where when we fought Sif, I said that if you beat the DLC before you fight him, then his cutscene changes because he actually appears in the DLC, and then he'll remember you from the DLC. What am I doing? I'm just, like, spacing out because I don't know what to do next. I want to actually go down to Blight Town because there's something that... dude, what are you doing? There's something that can happen. Ooh, what we got? A longsword. Hey, you know what I'm going to do? I'm gonna see if I can make this jump. Hup! Hey, I actually made it! Oh my god, I don't believe it! And actually, there's somebody else over here, I think. Yeah, hey, it's you. It's this guy. This guy we met in the sewers. I don't know what the hell he's doing sitting over here, but...
Aishimite. I suppose great minds think alike, eh?
I'm so happy. You can buy a master key from this guy? I didn't know that. That's crazy. This guy sells boss armors. You can get the armor of the Iron Golem. Smo. That's it, I guess. Smo's armor is ridiculously heavy. All this armor is ridiculously heavy. Jesus Christ. Yeah, see, you can see that by wearing Smo's armor. Smo's armor is actually... that's not actually what he looks like underneath it. He's apparently, like, super jacked under the armor, which is kind of scary. I'm sorry. Stop talking, man. Jesus Christ. But anyway, yeah. So, at this point, the game kind of opens up. And I have an idea of what I want to do first, because it's the most natural thing to do first, in my humble opinion, but at the same time, I'm not 100% sure. Hey, Logan! What's up, man?
Hello there. I was expecting you.
Man, I love how he sits so all you can see is his big, stupid hat.
I'm afraid the basic framework, you see. Oh, do not fret. Don't frown with regret.
Oh, he says that because my intelligence isn't high enough to learn any of his stuff. To use any of his stuff. But then he encourages you that, like, hey, you know, you don't need sorcery to be cool. It's okay. And you know what? I appreciate the man. It's nice that the NPCs in this game are, like, for the most part, seem to be fairly well-adjusted individuals. It's like, where am I going? Oh my god, I am just spacing out and wandering around with not a care in the world, and I sound like an idiot, and I look like an idiot, and I probably smell like one, too. What do I do? 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 Well, I'll tell you what the thing that I want to do next first is... What? Is the next area that I usually go to is New Londo, because now we can actually... Now that we have that ring we got from Sif, we can actually finish that area. Why is there any of the evil eye at the very end? That's weird. You can actually finish this area, the area now that we have the Covenant of Artorias. If we didn't have this, we'd be able to make it all the way to the very, very end, but we wouldn't be able to actually finish the area. Can I perchance? No. Can I perchance? No, I'm still. Oh, I'm so close. If I could just get a little bit less weight. If I switched my shield, that would do it. Yeah, the leather armor is heavier than the shadow garb. I'll stick with the shadow garb for a while. I could put the thief mask on. That would definitely push me over the edge. It'd be fast rolling again. Yeah, fast rolling without. Oh my god, that's good. Fast rolling without needing Havel's set. We only need like one more level to get that with the with our helmet on too. I'm gonna put on the Covetous Gold Serpent Ring, and I actually want to hop down to Blighttown because, man, that's really the closest. You can warp to the Darkmoon Tomb? I didn't know that. Hey, I have my phone here. I'm gonna look up where to get that ring that I mentioned in the last episode because I don't remember. This is, I'm warning you, the next couple episodes, oh shoot, we should do that right now too. Ooh, now that we have the ability to warp, we should do this. I totally forgot about the fair lady here. I really want to do her, like, little mini quest here, because it can, if we do it, then we can actually, okay, hang on, where is it? Dark Moon Seance Ring. There we go. That's what it is. Where do you find this thing? How do you get the Darkmoon Seance Ring? It's in the catacombs. Okay. Okay, we'll go back and we'll go back there and finish exploring that fairly soon. Do I have enough humanity to do this? No, I don't. In order to do what we want to do with Quelag's sister here, we need 30 humanity. Because basically what her covenant is all about is you'll enter covenant with her, and all you do basically in that covenant is feed her humanity. You just offer her humanity and you gain like little benefits at certain thresholds, and 30 is the highest threshold that actually offers you a tangible reward, and it offers you that reward in the form of a shortcut to the area at the end of like the demon ruins path. And actually allows you to skip two bosses. But more importantly, because I'm gonna fight those two bosses eventually anyway, more importantly, it allows you to circumvent the natural progression of one of the NPC's quest lines and actually save their life. Which I'm going to do, because not only do you get to save their life, but in the process, you get an extremely useful piece of equipment for exploring the Tomb of the Giants. So I'm definitely going to do that. I should have upgraded my Pyromancy Flame before I came here. If you have a plus 10 Pyromancy Flame, then you can find an NPC right there. Next to this pillar, just on that little beach there. And but you need to have a pyromancy flame that's up to plus 10 to find that NPC before that NPC will appear. And I don't actually like. I'm probably not actually gonna do much with that NPC because I haven't really been using that much pyromancy. Although that's gonna change actually once we enter covenant with the fair lady, because when you enter covenant with her, you can get an extremely useful pyromancy from her that is definitely going to be going on that I'm definitely going to attune as soon as possible, because it is so nice to have for a little bit of extra ranged attack. The pain, oh my god. I really wish you could warp to this bonfire. Oh, you know what else we could do now? Now that we have the ability to warp, we can go down the Great Hollow. Because the reason why I didn't go down the Great Hollow before, when we first dipped our toes into it, is because in order to get back up without warping, we would need to climb all the way back up, which is just a huge pain in the ass, and I didn't want to deal with that shit. So, yeah, like... So, yeah, I didn't want to deal with that. But now that we have the ability to warp, we can just go to the bottom. Hey, Sigmire! That's the other reason why I wanted to come down here. The main reason why I wanted to come down here was actually to meet Sigmire there, because after you talk to him in Firelink Shrine, this is the next place he appears. But I also wanted to see if I could get nothing, nothing, nothing? Nothing? Well, screw you too, Ludwig von Koopa. Oh my god. Yeah, I wanted to come down here, kill the leeches for a few more large shards. Just grind a little bit of Titanite, and also advance his quest line. Because his quest line is definitely worth advancing. I don't know if I'll do it right. There are a couple ways. Most of the NPCs in this game have, like, a few ways that their quest line can end. And Sigmire's is one of the hardest to get, to get a specific ending on. Well, not... It's one of the hardest to get the quote-unquote best end, the most complete ending on. Because of what happens in his second-to-last encounter. But I'm not gonna, get into spoilers or anything. Dude! Oh my god! You know what I should do? I should pop some humanity. Let me pop a twin humanity. Hey man, what's good? You're asleep. You're asleep. Hello?
Oh-ho!
Standing up in the middle of a poisoned swamp. That's not how you spell antidote. Okay, Toadsworth. Mario Party 7-ass Toadsworth. Here you go. Ooh, the Pierce Shield. Cool. Anyway, I forgot you actually had to do something here. You gotta help him out. You gotta give him some moss so he can get the fuck out of here. Man, you do not want to drop any... You guys don't want to drop any fucking shit today, do you? There we go. One. You dropped something, too. Okay, there we go. That's two. I wish it was easier to get these. In Dark Souls 3, I've been playing Dark Souls 3 on stream. I need to start posting the VODs from that. Put them in the playlist or whatever. The problem is that they've all happened like years apart from each other, you know. Like this one, I mean, hell, it's not even one playthrough at this point because I lost my save data and had to get back up to where I was because that game doesn't have cloud saving for some reason. Oh my god, what am I doing? Why am I making you watch this? I mean, I'm not- Oh my god! Oh, the ragdoll physics in this game are an absolute gift. Hey, die. Man! Ass for drops today, man. I tell you what, man. These are terrible. Okay. Well, I'm not gonna do another pass of these guys now. I think I probably have plenty. Yeah, I got 11 shards. You only need, like, 12, is that right? To get them up to... Well, because it's like 1... 1, 1, 2, 2... 3? Yeah, because you get them up to plus 5. Yes, yes, okay. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, so it's 9. You need 9 shards to get it up to level something up. 9 of each shard per weapon you want to, like, level up fully. Except chunks. I think chunks you only actually need 6, because when you get to plus 14, you get it to plus 15 with a slab. Oh, you know what? I need to go do that, too. Okay. I really should do this right now, but I don't want to. What I want to do right now is I want to warp over to the sewers, the depths, because I want to go get the last of the humanity we need to help the fair lady, because we'll do that in the next episode. This shouldn't take too long. These rats have about, like, I think like a 5% chance naturally to drop humanity. So our item discovery is up to 358, which means it's essentially being multiplied by 3.58. So it's actually like 15%, and that's pretty good. This shouldn't take too long. Well, that's not a good start. But this is basically how I've always done this. Grinding humanity. I mean, this is the best place as far as I know. I don't know if there's anywhere better to grind humanity than right here, just killing these 10 rats over and over. Thankfully, we don't need much. All we need is... Well, drop some! Hello! Oh my god! All we need is, how much do we need, actually? We have 2 soft right now, and then we're gonna have... Yeah, 6 more. So we currently have 24 humanity, so all we need is 6 drops and we'll have 30. And then I'll probably grind a little bit more off screen. You know what I should do, actually, is pop like 8 more, because the bonus that you get maxes out at 10 soft humanity and gives us 410 item discovery. You can see the diminishing returns at play there. Like, 2 item discovery gave us an extra 50%. Like 58% item discovery. And then the remaining 8 brought us up like another 70%, or like 60%, you know. So yeah, but it can be worth it. I mean, plus 50 plus like 60%, that's like another 2% or something. Or plus like 4%. Like, aren't we up to like, wouldn't we be up to almost like 20% by now? Yeah, we're like, yeah, something like that. But anyway. Dude, this thing is so annoying. How did I get poisoned? Oh, I actually took, dude. Man, you guys don't want to drop any freaking humanity, do you? Oh, jeez. Oh, man, this poison hurts a lot more than the poison in the swamp. Yeah, there are actually, like, different levels of poison, which I never realized until I was watching some video. I think I actually learned about that in an Elden Ring video, one of Rusty's videos. But yeah, there are actually, like, multiple levels of poison beyond just poisoned and toxic. There's actually, like, 2 different kinds of... There's actually, like, 2 different severities of poison even before you get into toxic. There's also 2 levels of poison. There we go. Okay, 1. You can actually also, if you remember that area, where that area is where there were the 3 giant rats on that balcony where the channeler was, you can actually kill those guys, and they have a chance of dropping twin humanities, which is pretty good. But obviously the drop rate on that is significantly... Dude! Okay. Oh my god. Dude, get off me! Ugh! The drop rate on the twin humanities is significantly lower, and I don't remember where that is either, so I don't know if it would be more effective to run over there for the possible chance, because I think they also have a higher chance of dropping a single humanity, but the fact that I don't know how to get to that little balcony area from here basically erases the time advantage that, you know, would probably erase any potential speed benefit I would gain from grinding there over anywhere else. So... Ow, God, ow! Ow, God, oh, oh, man, this is, I mean, Venusaur! God, I just watched that again yesterday. God, that video was funny. I am so glad, I mean, okay, Poke Awesome 2 wasn't as good, but I'm glad that, like, I'm glad that some of the last couple awesome videos, like, awesome series videos that Aaron did were also, like, two, like, that and A Link to the Past were both, like, you know, long-awaited, huge, like, you know, big games to parody and also really funny. But God, Poke Awesome is just inimitable, man. What? You can close that door? Why would I want it to... Why would I want to do that? Okay. Man, can I just say also, my Bluetooth headphones have not dipped out once this entire video, and granted, I haven't been doing much. I've been wandering around a lot killing like wimps, but the fact that it hasn't cut out at all makes me extremely happy. And I think it might be because I closed my Chrome. I think I just need to, because like I was playing Dark Souls 3 and I didn't have any of these problems at all. And from what I understand, Dark Souls 3's PC port is, if occasionally unstable, really well optimized. So it might just be that I need to mitigate my CPU usage to keep my Bluetooth connection strong. Dude! Would you begoush? Dude! Stop it. Get some help. Stop it. Go up. Dude, you were going up. Yoshi, you should have ducked. How much do I have? I have 10, plus 10, plus... I need one more! Ugh! Did you actually just die? Oh, man. Poor girl died to rats. I don't want to make fun. I'm sure I died to rats at least once on my first playthrough. And sometimes you just get ganked and there's nothing you can do, man. I don't know. Anyway. I think somebody else here has the same idea. I think this person is also grinding rats. Although, actually, I think they've been standing there for, like, a while. I definitely don't think I'm the only person grinding rats right now, which is very funny. I guess I could... Well, why would I do that? I was gonna say, I guess I could reverse my hollowing. Why would I do that? What, so I can get invaded and killed? Well, you might beat them and get a humanity! Yeah, or I could just, like, you know... No. I'm not doing that. That's stupid. That we have enough now. We got that one drop at the beginning of this cycle, so... We officially have all the humanity we need... to get what we need to do... to get what we need to get... Which means it's time for me to end this video, and I think I'll probably off-screen I'll do a little bit more grinding here and get some more humanity, and that'll also give me a chance to get my throat a rest and check my, I don't know, whatever. If I do plan on recording more, I'm kind of liking, you know, recording the day of again, though. It's nice. So, sorry for the kind of a nothing episode. Oh man, my leg is bugging out. Sorry for kind of a nothing episode. We placed the Lordvessel. Dude, get that rest at bonfire thing out of here. We placed the Lordvessel, opened up some paths, none of which I had ever shown you before, so you have no fucking idea where they are. Opening up Act 2, and, then ran around a whole bunch prepping for other, you know, errands. Sorry for the, you know, lame way to open, a bit of a lame way to open Act 2, but oh well, we'll get there. After, I think next episode we'll open that shortcut, and then probably, oh jeez, I want to do that right now. Push forward in the demon rooms, because you do actually have to push forward a little bit to get to where that shortcut opens up. Well, we'll see. Next time, we'll, go soothe the pain of a fair lady. Mmm, bah!